not only are we unique because of our funding source from our local community foundation, but we're unique in our focus in terms of focusing on policy as a way to effectively address alcohol and other drug problems. Through New Futures Community Leadership Initiative, we have trained over 1,000 New Hampshire citizens to become effective advocates. It is the voice of these citizens, whether that voice is heard through letter, email, testimony, or phone call, that really makes the difference in impacting policy in New Hampshire. New Futures has to do with the promise of having a state where policies ensure that people can access treatment for addiction and where policies are in place that improve our quality of life here in New Hampshire by reducing the issues associated with alcohol and other drugs. We at New Futures know that addiction is a chronic brain disease that can be effectively treated. We also know that prevention works, and it's extraordinarily important for us to focus on preventing these problems before they become addictions.
As an advocate interested in speaking to a House committee or participating in the House process, you would come into a committee room like this. As you can see, the tables in this direction are set up to seat about 20 people. And that makes sense because there are 400 state representatives and there are 20 standing committees. So it's about 20 legislators per committee. House members serve only on one committee. As you look at this setup for the committee, you'll see that there's one large chair. That chair belongs to the chairman of the committee. The table right there is where people who are speaking to the committee sit when they are testifying. The chairs right here are where the members of the public sit during the course of a public hearing. If you come to this room to participate in the process and you don't have a copy of the bill that is being heard, if you look right behind on the wall, there are a plastic set of files, and the bills for that day will be there, and you can pick up a copy of the bill to use it as part of your work when you're in the room.
While I might be the paid lobbyist from New Futures, what really matters is the volunteer lobbyists that come in and lobby the State House. It's not very scary to do. It's a very receptive audience. In fact, I think when committee members look out into the audience and they see me and other lobbyists sitting there, they're like, you know, all right, here we go again. But when actual constituents come in, they really listen to them and they want information from those folks about how this piece of legislation is going to impact their lives or impact their business. And so the role of me as a lobbyist sometimes is really encouraging real people to come to the legislature and lobby on behalf of issues that are important to them.
We are now entering the historic House of Representatives. The House of Representatives has seats for the 400 state representatives. The boxes on the seats, as you will see here, these wooden boxes are the electronic voting system for the House of Representatives. It should be noted that the voting system began in 1974, and we are still using the same voting system after all these years. State representatives sit in assigned seats. They are assigned by the Speaker of the House. And when the members gather in this room, they gather and sit in their assigned seats. There is a very strict decorum on behavior in the House of Representatives. Members are not allowed to speak unless recognized by the Speaker of the House. The Speaker of the House presides up here at the front head podium, looking out over the 399 members.
So this gets us to the point in the process where the bill has been written and all of the sponsors have signed off on the bill and it's ready to go. And for the purposes of this discussion, we will assume that the prime sponsor on this bill is a House member, which means the bill will start in the House and it will have HB, that stands for House Bill, and then it will have a number. If it had started in the Senate, it would be SB and have a number. So we have House Bill and then a number.
citizens can come to the State House and testify before a committee. It may seem like it's daunting, but we're just 20 ordinary citizens, just like those that are coming to talk to us and share what they know about a particular issue.
In the budget debate, we had debates over the level of funding for substance abuse last year, and you left not real thrilled with the decision that I felt that we had to make. But as an advocate, I think you knew that it was important never to burn bridges and approached me, you know, this year to sponsor the legislation that we talked about in terms of prescription drug monitoring.
So picking up the phone and calling a legislator at home, that is our office, or writing us a letter or sending us an email and talking specifically about your personal experiences or knowledge or information that will help shed light and enhance the conversation and the debate about any particular bill that's before us is very, very important. And I certainly, as a legislator, I certainly welcome that.
I think that decisions get made. You don't always win. You don't always lose. And as long as there's mutual respect and the ability to disagree in an agreeable fashion, that's really important, both for the elected official and for advocates.